Amen.
It's a good day.
Yes, it is.
Good day in spite of life's trials and tribulations. It's still indeed a good day.
A good day.
To my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to my pastor, Pastor Harris, to Reverend Terry, Minister Terry, and the waiting congregation, it is indeed a pleasure to be able to stand before my family.
Yeah.
And speak about our theme, hidden history.
All right.
But before we get to that hidden history, I just want y'all to know that I know Barack Obama firsthand.
All right.
Hidden history. Another program says Luke, Numbers 13, 12, 2 and 3. But I was toiling between two scriptures, two sets of scriptures, and I opted to go the opposite direction. Proverbs 2, 1 through 5. My son, if thou wilt receive my words and hide my commandments with thee, so that thou incline thine ear unto wisdom and apply thine heart to understanding. Yea, if thou criest after knowledge and lift up thy voice for understanding, if thou seekest her as silver and searchest her as hidden treasure, then shall thou understand the fear of the Lord and find knowledge in God. Hidden history. We focus on hidden. Hidden says that I am to put away out of sight, secret, to conceal. But let us not get misled on those different words, out of sight, secret, concealed. It tends to make you mindful that I'm hiding something that I'm not willing to share. But in this particular setting, the word hidden refers to where I'm hiding my treasures at. History, a chronological record of events, the study of past events. Many times our topics gives us indications or statements, whether if they be informative or even sober. But our topic today gives us instructions because of vanity. It instructs us to protect our chronological records of events. In other words, it tells us to protect history and preserve the study of those past events. Because of this, because it is so valuable to generations to come, hidden history. What history is so important to us as people that we are to hide it, conceal it, to keep it secret? It's the word of God.
All right.
Our first verse tells us to receive his words. The sayings of God are to be received and the commandments to be hid or stored up. Now this concealment is not one that carries the weight of not sharing, but it carries the weight of where I'm keeping my prize to share later, at a later date. Proverbs 7:1 tells me, my son, keep my words and treasure my commandments within you. So where is it that we should keep these precious, valuable history? It tells us in verse 2. It says to us to incline our ear. In other words, keep your ear open. If something is to enter into the head, it has to go through the ear. But its final destination is the heart. When the word of God gets into the heart, it brings understanding. God's word is intended to be kept in the hearts of men.
All right.
The secret place.
Yes.
The hiding place.
Uh-huh.
I know someone is wondering why the heart.
Mm-hmm.
Proverbs 4:23 tells us, keep thy heart with all diligence.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
For out of the heart, are the issues of life.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We must be watchful.
Mm-hmm.
And keep a watchful eye and a strict hand on all the motions of our inward man.
Uh-huh.
God, who gave us these souls, gave us a strict charge
mm-hmm.
with them. We must set a strict guard
uh-huh.
on all avenues of the soul,
mm-hmm.
not being defiled by sin,
all right.
distributed by trouble,
mm-hmm.
and keeping out bad thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
The issues of life.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Out of a heart well kept will flow living issues.
Yeah.
Good products.
Mm-hmm.
To the glory of God and edification of others.
All right.
We must seek after knowledge of the word of God as a minor search for silver or something that's very valuable.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
A minor is very persistent
mm-hmm.
and hopeful about his search.
Mm-hmm.
He knows what's hidden is both precious
yeah.
and valuable.
All right.
So is the word of God.
All right.
As a matter of fact, it's more precious or valuable.
Mm-hmm.
Our forefathers stood on the value.
Yeah.
They understood its keeping power.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They knew it was our identity.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And that it had to be passed on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you don't mind, you give me just a few seconds.
Come on, come on.
Pass on some hidden history.
Come on.
Some history that we should keep within our heart mm-hmm. to pass on.
Yeah.
John says in 3:16, for God
so loved the world
that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth
in him
should not perish,
but have everlasting life.
Hidden
history. Come on.
Paul says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature.
All things are passed away.
Behold, all things become new.
Come on.
Hidden history. History that we possess on the inside. History that our young people need to know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Philippians 4:13.
I can do all things through Christ.
Look at
Christ strengthens me.
Yeah.
Isaiah brings some light in the 54th chapter, 17th verse.
Uh-huh.
He says, no weapon formed
against me shall prosper.
Hidden history that we need to pass down.
Yeah.
What about Jeremiah? Jeremiah 17:7. Blessed is the man
that trusted in the Lord.
and whose hope the Lord is.
Mm-hmm.
Moses tells us in Exodus 20:12, honor thou father and thy mother, that thy days might be long upon this land, which the Lord thy God giveth these.
Yeah.
Hidden
history.
History.
Come on.
Yeah. David says, Psalms 46:1, God is our refuge and our strength,
mm-hmm.
a very present
help
in trouble. Can I stay with David just for a little
while? Come on.
Psalms 30:5, the latter portion of that verse, because somewhere in life, there's going to come a time when mother's gone,
uh-huh.
when father's gone,
uh-huh.
when we lose siblings,
mm-hmm.
we lose aunts
yeah.
and uncles. He reminds us that weeping
may endure
in the morning.
Yeah.
David says in Psalms 37:25, I've been young and now I'm old.
Yeah.
Yet I've not seen the righteous forsaken, nor seen their glory. Our youth have been acting out part on tonight to question or to help us understand our history.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I would just like to extend that if I could.
Come on.
Class.
Yeah. Come on.
Class.
Uh-huh.
Class.
All right.
Who am I?
Who am I?
Some call me bread.
Mm.
Sorry,
woo!
Pay attention now. I am Alpha.
And Omega.
And Omega.
Beginning and the end. And the end.
And the end.
Come on.
Past.
Yeah.
Who am I?
Ah.
I am love.
Yeah.
Past.
Yeah.
Who am I?
Yeah.
I'm the perfect sacrifice.
Yeah.
Come on.
Past.
Yeah.
Pay attention, Clay.
Yeah.
I was betrayed by the kids. Who am I?
Yeah.
They led me from judgment hall to judgment hall.
Yeah.
Who am I?
Yeah.
Past.
Yeah.
Pay attention now. They carried me to Calvary's cross.
Yeah.
They scratched me wide.
Yeah.
Past.
Yeah.
Who am I?
Yeah.
They dropped me low.
Yeah.
But in the midst of dying.
Yeah.
Past.
Yeah.
Who am I?
Come on.
I saved a sinner.
Yeah.
To the right of it.
Yeah.
Who am I?
Woo.
I used the boring tomb.
Come on.
Past. Pay attention.
Yeah. Come on.
Who am I?
Yeah.
On the third day I got up.
Yeah.
I went to the club and have anybody to go.
Yeah.
I stood and I said,
yeah.
Class?
Class.
Yeah.
Class.
Class.
Class?
Yeah.
Pay
yeah.
attention now, class.
Yeah.
Who am I?
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
Whoa, man. Malo.